because developed economies were stumbling again, slashing demand for other exports. The government says it now not only has the right projects at lower prices, it's also improved budgeting and disbursement. Public Works and Highway Secretary Rogelio Singson, who will be responsible for most of the infra projects, told us spending and construction will jump next year. Secretary Abad says 140 billion pesos of infra projects are ready to go in January. 125 of those is under DPWH. You've said you've done some of the procurement work just short of award. Does this mean that on January 2, on Monday, after this weekend, we're going to see a whole lot of construction beginning?
That's correct, Coco. Unlike in 2011, where the projects were line item and many of the projects were still under lump sums. No? Lump sums need a long clearance procedures. No? Now, in the case of 2012, all were practically line items, no? Disaggregated, which means we had the opportunity to identify and do a lot of preparatory work, preparing programs of work and advertising and bidding them out.
In other words, award. On January 2, you're not going to be scratching your head saying what project should we do.
No, you know what project to do. We know exactly what projects, and we will no longer accept realignments, which is what we encountered in 2011.
Now, your statement is that you've gone so far in terms of procuring these projects just short of award.
That's correct.
And the awarding is necessary before you actually start the project. When are the awards going to happen? We have a window of 3 or 4 months of sunny weather. When are the awards going to happen? When is construction going to start?
The construction actually starts as soon as I sign those contracts. And what I need to be able to sign and commit those contracts would be the release from DBM that these are the funds that you are allotted for this year.
Mm-hmm. Could that happen on January 2, or will some of that happen in January?
Just to give you a flavor, quarter one this year, 2011, we were able to disburse 5.5 billion. Compare that to what we expect to disburse in 2012, about 25 to 30 billion.
So yeah. Five times or more.
That's correct. And the second quarter, it will ramp up some more, 33 billion compared to about 11.6 billion in 2011. So the story in 2012 will be totally different.
Could you tell us how difficult it was to find these kinds of problems? And then solve them?
That was part of the reform agenda. No? And I just had to be very cautious in terms of looking at science. No? For example, one district has about 300-400 million worth of projects. When these projects were bidded out, all the bids came within a 2.5% of our agency estimate. Mm-hmm. Consistently. You
know, magaling na.
Magaling lumuto.
Are these bidders blacklisted now?
We warned them, okay. And we pulled out.
Because you don't have proof, right?
It's difficult to prove.
Yes.
Okay. We warned them.
How many, if any, bidders or contractors have been blacklisted?
There are quite a few that have been blacklisted in the past. No? But, you know, blacklisting is not a guarantee. They can always register a new name
right.
No, under the same owners. No.
So the onus is on the agency to make sure that the bidding is proper.
That's correct. Right? That's correct.
Could you tell us what the vision is? You know, everyone says the Philippines is ready for takeoff, but one of the big problems is the infrastructure. Could you tell us what your vision or the president's vision is for infrastructure in this country 2016?
Okay.
What country are we going to look like?
Our commitment is national roads is our responsibility. Our national roads, all 31,000 kilometers. Half of that is what we refer to as primary roads. Secondary roads would be the second category. By 2014, we're committing that the quality of our national primary roads will be upgraded in terms of quality and safety. By 2016, all the secondary roads will be upgraded. Now, in addition to that, we have bridges on our national roads. By 2016, all of our bridges will now become permanent. We still have bridges in main roads that are made of wood and temporary. I mean, all these years.
So 2016 is our infrastructure, roads and bridges, going to be equal to first world level.
I'm benchmarking against Malaysia.
How much priority do you feel the president and the government is giving to that?
Very, very high priority. We're always monitored by the president, the economic cluster, which includes the infra agencies as well as the economic managers.
How much pressure is the president putting on you?
A little too much. No, kidding aside, we are really being monitored practically on a regular basis. Weekly among the economic managers, and on a regular basis we get called in.
Next, Europe threatens the world with a double dip recession. Stay with us.